Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and today I will talk about why image literals are missing from Xcode. So without further ado, let's dive into the code. Okay, now if you open up an older project that has been created prior Xcode 10, and you open it up in Xcode 10, you will see if you have images, UI images, you will see this default image instead of the actual image that has been added with image literals. Now, image literals are, of course, when you just type in the name, you just start typing in the name of the image, and then you just select the one that you want, and then it hit return, and it basically adds it into the code with a little icon representing the actual image. Okay, now I will just show you because basically image literals haven't been removed from Xcode 10, just the autocompletion has been removed. Now let me just create a new project and show you what to do. So I just copy this and let's create a new project. Go to File, New and Project, and let it be a single view application. Click on Next and let's say a re-autocompletion, because the autocompletion has been removed. Okay, a real wrong product name, but that's what it is. Okay, and I will just drop it onto the desktop. Okay. Let me just make this so you may see it better. Now, let's go to our view controller here and let's paste the code that we have just copied from my previous project. And as you can see, the default image is presented. Okay, now how to fix this? Well, first of all, we need to add our assets. Okay, so I will just drag and drop this one and let me just see which one is it. Yeah, it's the slowest. Okay, and here we go, slideshow slowest. Let's drag and drop it into our asset folder. Great, there we go. And if we just build this project with command B, nothing really happens. It doesn't really Xcode doesn't really get it that we have added that image. And if we just try to type in image view image equals and slideshow, you see that it doesn't really autocomplete, and that is the feature that has been removed. Now, the old way of adding this is through the UI image initialization. So UI image, and we will choose the one with the named, and I will just add this string here. Now this is kind of cumbersome, and that is what image literals basically solved, this whole copy and pasting, and it was very typo it wasn't really typo proof. That's what I'm trying to say. And now we do have it, but you know, we have this slideshow slowest. What is that really? We would rather like to see the actual image, a little thumbnail of that image in our Xcode editor. Now, that is what we are going to learn today. So, if we just comment out the first line, you will see that actually, basically, the image literals haven't been removed from Xcode. And this is with the resource name and, of course, with slideshow slowest. Now, let's just comment out the old way of doing it and let's add the new way of doing it. So, the Xcode 10 way. So, IV image view dot image equals, and now we want to add our image literal. Again, typing in the name of the image that will not work as of Xcode 10. And now, what we need to do is, and here's a little shortcut for our media library, because we want to bring up the media library, and that is pretty simple, and basically it's kind of the same, and it's not that time consuming either. So hit Shift Command M, Again, Shift Command M, and your media library will pop up. And let me just take this here. It's real nice to see it here. And of course, if you just simply tap away from your media library, it will basically disappear. Again, Shift Command M, and you will see. Now, what you need to do is drag and drop it into your Xcode, into your code. And again, what gives? It still is the basic old default thumbnail for this image. Now, most probably this is an issue with Xcode 10. Maybe it will be fixed in later versions, but what I found out is that if you have more than one images in your assets, then this will work. So let us just delete this for now. Oh, not that one, the default value here. And let's add another for slideshow fastest. Okay, let's go to the assets folder again. And here we go, slideshow fastest. There we go, hit Command B. So everything compiles. Of course, build has failed because here we need to drag our image. Okay, hit Command, Shift Command M again, and let's drag and drop the slideshow. Okay, most probably, if this doesn't work for you, then go ahead, and it worked in other project of my own. This is why I think this is a bug that will be fixed sooner or later. Now, what I found is that if you double tap on it, you will see what it actually is, and you can select from the media library. Now, once you double tapped, you will see that it actually is there. The thumbnail of the image is there. So let me just type in with rendering bowl mode, always original. Great. Now, after this double tapping and maybe selecting it, it is optional to select a new image. After this double tapping, everything goes into place. We do have our image literal representations of our images in there. And if we just comment this out, you will see the first line now auto-completes as, it doesn't auto-complete. Auto-completion has been removed. It displays the image thumbnail as it should. So let me just comment out that one. And just as a proof, let me just copy and paste the other code here, slideshow fastest image view. I've just copied this, and that one is with the rabbit, and I will just paste it in there. And as you can see, the one with the rabbit also got fixed. Again, you will not be able to have that auto completion that was prior to Xcode 10. So you need to hit Shift Command M to bring up the media library. Now, Shift Command M is a great shortcut for our media library, but if you want to change that, simply just go to Xcode Preferences and go into, I believe it's Keybindings, yes it is, and under Filter type in Media. And there you go, you can change the default shortcut for that. Now, that is it for today for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit that notification bell, I dare you. And go ahead and comment down below. Do you think that this is actually a kind of a small bug introduced in Xcode 10, or, well, do you think that this will be as is? We always have the default images in our upcoming projects. Go ahead and comment down below what do you think. And as always, I will see you in the next one.